Okay, so this will literally be my first attempt at Stable Diffusion's DreamStudio web app. Apparently they transitioned from using Discord with free services to this web model that is going to cost you after your first 200 free credits. So let's use them up and explore how this works. So right off the bat, I can see we've got square image and some controllers on the side that allow you to modify, let's see, the width of the image, yes. And you may not be familiar with pixels, but in order to get, this looks like a 1x2, and then if you bump this up a notch, it'll give you a 16x9, which I like to render at, just so that we're always prepared to use it for various media types. CFG scale looks like it will create either more abstract or more accurate image. It starts you off at a 7, so let's see what that does. Steps looks like it's going to give you maybe more definition or less, so I don't know. Let's slide that kind of right towards the middle. Number of images, you can either have a grid or just stick with your one that it'll produce. Let's see how that affects the credits. It does not, so okay, why not? Let's see if we can explore four images at a time. Something similar to Midjourney and DALL-E. And the sampler, I'm not exactly sure. Diffusion sampling method default is okay. Sure, we'll leave it like that. So right off the bat, I have no idea how it's going to accept these prompts, so let's just start with something simple like a cinematic photo of an architectural villa in Santorini during sunrise. And let's check it out. So rendering looks a bit slower. I'm not sure if some of these parameters have an effect on that. Maybe producing one image instead of four would be a little quicker. We can test that out in a minute here, but not too bad. Some of the other models, it's nice to see the images being rendered, but maybe with the web app in its early development stages, it's trying to use less power here. So we get something here that looks very typical of what you would imagine a Santorini village to look like. So now that we know that it produces some very realistic photographic looking images, let's give it a little spin. A cinematic photo of a futuristic flowing angular architectural villa with an illuminated pool in Santorini during sunrise. And let's just throw in like a little foggy. And now let's bump down the number of images. Let's see, just one. We'll see if it goes quicker. And it does not. It seems like it's generating at about the same speed. And we did get this bump up here, the seed, which looks like if you do multiple images, you're going to receive basically four random seeds. But if you do an individual image, you get to either choose your seed or it'll select it at random. Okay, so we have an image now that is not exactly what I am imagining based on my experiences with DALL-E and Midjourney. This is a little more, it's definitely scenic and photographic, but it's not as imaginative. So let's take a scale here for the CFG, and let's see, higher values keep your image closer to the prompt. Okay, so let's go away from the prompt a little bit and let it imagine, and let's add cinematic aerial photo of a futuristic flowing angular architectural villa with an illuminated pool in Santorini during sunrise with landscaping, native landscaping, foggy. It took the foggy prompt pretty well, so let's see how it works with this. Anything else you want to change? No. And actually, I mean, I'm just blowing through my credits here. It looks like each of these images is going to be about 7.4 credits, so we'll take a look at how many credits we have left shortly, but let's produce this. Again, rendering a bit slower. So I did see, you know, and we will review some of the pricing options for this as compared to DALL-E and Midjourney. Right now, I do have a subscription with Midjourney, and for the amount of images you can generate, it seems fair. A lot of people are complaining about DALL-E being pricey, and it does seem very pricey. Okay, so this is definitely producing very realistic photographic imagery, which is nice to see. Let's work at trying to get it a little more singular, and I'm wondering if we can substitute the Santorini, because it seems to be drawing from a collection of images that is very maybe stereotypical or typical of what you would expect to see. So maybe a pool, we'll take this pool during sunrise, cinematic aerial photo, futuristic flowing angular architectural villa with an illuminated pool. Let's see if we change this to a cinematic cliffside photo of a futuristic flowing angular architectural villa. Not sure if the commas make a difference here, but we'll give this a try and see if how much weight, I guess, some of these words or prompts carry, because if just placing in Santorini is making these images very Santorini-like, then we're going to want to just remove that and use some different descriptive words. I'll also try sliding the CFG scale, I think, all the way up to see if we can get something that's a little more close to our prompt. Okay, so this is getting me something a little closer. It looks like we've got some architecture here. It looks a little bit futuristic. I'm going to add a few more descriptive prompts in here, something like architectural villa, illuminated pool during sunrise, and foggy, artificial lighting, accent lighting. Let's see, what else can we put here? I'm not really getting the flowing angular architecture, so let's take out angular and just put flowing. Curious to see. Sinuous and curvilinear architectural villa. And let's see what that does, and then we'll bump up the CFG scale for comparison, because right now it seems to be taking some liberty away from, I guess, what I would imagine the prompt to be, but it is producing something along those lines, so it's fairly accurate, even in its abstract kind of generation of this prompt. So we're rendering, we're almost done here. I've got to say, I'm pretty impressed with the photographic quality of the images. So this is, again, it's very abstract. I think it's getting a little too abstract for my preferences. Let's just bump it all the way up and do a comparison so we can see side by side. So yeah, as I was saying, pretty impressed by the photographic quality. I imagine if you substitute the word photo with rendering or an art style, it'll be also accurate and impressive with those stylings, but we've only got a certain number of credits here, so let's kind of stick to the script. And okay, so now we are getting something that is more in line with my expectations, and maybe we can give it a little bit of freedom there, and I can back out a little bit here by adding some more regulated descriptive words, flowing, sinuous, curvilinear. Sinuous always gives a very, very curvaceous, so we'll take that out. And let's put back in curvilinear, angular, and modern. Modern is going to give us some traditional straight lines, glass, storefront systems, I think. So let's kind of give that a try. So I can see this DreamStudio Stability AI's Stable Diffusion in its web app form, DreamStudio Beta. Definitely more approachable for maybe the general public who are not familiar with Discord and signing up and working through that forum. Okay, so yeah, we're getting a little closer to something that would be more typical that I would produce. But overall, I would say that this is very user-friendly. I think we'll take a look at like the history here, and as you can see, it gives you some images, but I'm not able to really click on them or expand them. So I have seen comments about this before saying that you know, people are wishing that they had a better history storage method of images. It looks like you can re-dream it, which means basically reproduce it. I don't know if that's going to take off some of my credits, so I'm not going to do that. But what that does mean is when you're in the dream mode, you have to download the image like when you have the opportunity, as of right now at least. And maybe that's just with the free credits and everything. Maybe that changes with your membership. I'm sorry, I'm not signing up for a membership right now, so I don't have those answers. But if you are looking to just take some samples, just a warning, you know, download them, the images as you produce them. Because if you do go to the history, you can't really download them here. If you open them in a new tab, they're relatively small. If you redream it, it's going to generate and take off from your credits that you have. And when you go back to Dream, it eliminates the image that was there. So we actually lost our entire prompt also, so that's not very fun. But anyway, we've got a prompt guide that maybe gives you a little more insight into how the generator will receive the prompts. You can just be very straightforward or add styles, very similar to DALL-E and Midjourney. So there you have it. Jump on in, see how it works for you, and curious to see what your thoughts are between the differences of Midjourney, DALL-E, and now DreamStudio by Stability AI. Thanks for watching, and see you guys soon.